Dear fifth semester basic students, as you know very well, I explain about the act first of the play A Doll's House. Let us consider, it is written by Henrik Ibsen, a Norwegian dramatist. It is a play, play means drama. It is a play written by Norwegian dramatist namely Henrik Ibsen. So let us consider the dramatic personae of this drama. Nora Helmer and Torvald Helmer are the husband and wife. Nora wife, Torvald husband. Duck Rank is another character who is very much friendly and visiting several times a day, visiting the home of Nora Torvald Helmer several times of the day and very friendly, and he is suffering from tuberculosis of the spine. Perhaps he had it gained from his parent. Another, Krishna Linde, is a very close friend of Nora Helmer, and she came back to the place, and after several years they met together. She had one lover named Nils Krogstad, who is working in a bank. Then children of Nora and Torvald Helmer are Ivar, Bobby and Emmy. So these three kids are this pair, and Annie Mary and Helen, the porter, are other characteristic features. I just explained the setting, the drama setting in the act one, what actually going on and how Torvald Helmer and Nora Helmer are very busy, especially Nora Helmer is very busy in preparing the Christmas party. So it is the day before, on the eve of Christmas day, Nora is preparing for everything, and she is going to give a surprise gift for Torvald Helmer. So these are some of the happenings, and let us see here what happens in this particular act one scene. A room furnished comfortably and tastefully. It's a well furnished room and arranged as according to their tastes, Nora's taste. At the back, a door to the right. So back side and right side, there is a door which enters into the central hall. Another to the left leads to Helmer's study. So another side, there is a study room of Torvald Helmer. Another door leads to his room. Between the doors, between these two doors, stands a piano. Usually foreigners, especially English people, usually they have interest on music. So piano is placed on the central of the hall. In the middle of the left hand wall is a door, and beyond it a window. Near the window are a round table armchairs. Near the window, round table armchairs and a small sofa before them. In the right hand wall at the farther end, another door. So on the other side there is another door. And on the same side, nearer the footlights, a stove, two easy chairs and a rocking chair. Between the stove and the door, a small table. Engraving on the walls, so something written. Engraving means written on the walls. A cabinet with china and other small objects. It's usually the utilizing materials for cooking and other things, and also for their decoration. A small bookcase with a well-round books, well-bound books. So there is a one bookcase. The floors are carpeted and fire burns in the stove. It is winter. It is usually winter time. The fire is burning. A bell rings in the hall. So by this time, someone came and rang the bell. Shortly afterwards, the door is heard to open. Enter Nora, humming a tune and in a high spirits, so making some sound. She is in outdoor dress and carries a number of parcels. She is bringing a number of parcels. These she lays on the table to the right. So she brought them and she kept them on the on the table there. She leaves the outer door open after her, and through it is seen a porter who is carrying a Christmas tree. So there comes one helper, porter, holding a Christmas tree on his hands. A basket, he is also handing a basket, which he gives to the maid who has opened the door. So Nora opened the door and the porter gave the Christmas tree and the basket. So now the story, the drama starts from here. Let us read what it contains. The first Nora's words: hide the Christmas tree carefully. See, she says, don't keep it open, because she intended to give a surprise visit to her husband named Torvald Helmer. So hide the Christmas tree carefully, Helen. Be sure the children do not see it. So she is suggesting these things to helper Helen, and keep it away from the children's eyes. It until this evening, when it is dressed, to the porter, taking out her purse. How much? So she is paying money, asking how much to the porter. So porter said the cost of the Christmas tree and basket is 6 pence. No, there is a shilling. No, keep the change. So she is asking back the change. The porter thanks her and goes out. Nora shuts the door. She is laughing to herself as she takes off her hat and coat. She takes a pocket of macaroons. There are some eatables, macaroons, from her pocket, and eats one or two, keeping one by one, one after the other. Then goes cautiously to her husband's door and listens. Yes, he is in. So she is confirming what her husband is, whether his husband is there inside or not. Yes, it is assured. Yes, he is inside the room. She goes to the table on the right, and once again she came to the table, which is on the right side.